charged with conspiring to corrupt Alderman Cunningham. How do you intend to plead, Mr. Smith?
I would plead guilty to that.
I think, to a large extent, we made the sense of some major mistakes. For example, the multi-storey car park near or within the city centre.
Dan Smith was
looking
setting up a succession of public relations companies.
Should have been much more sensible from
and
the point
of
view
were builders
of the
or contractors.
Immediate environment of the city to have
one of his employees
on the perimeter of the
Frieda
city,
Cunningham,
in particular in view of the fact
so
that
when I look at this, I say, without batting an eyelid, this was an honest scheme, but if it had been, I would rather have a scheme like this corruptly conceived than houses like we saw yesterday honestly conceived. And this wasn't a triumph for Newcastle democracy. It was a triumph over the democracy in Newcastle's housing over the previous 15 years.
So having resigned,
it was built with the systems building techniques advocated by a number of Dan Smith's public relations companies. Many of its flats are already boarded and empty, and the towers are shorted to be pulled down after a life of scarcely more than a decade. And since then, those three names, Smith, Cunningham and Poulsen, have become a sort of shabby collective brand name for corruption.
I couldn't understand the reason for the charge. I certainly knew that I wasn't guilty of it. And I didn't even understand the reason within my own organization at that time as to the kind of circumstances that subsequently became obvious to me.
It was then that he began to talk of turning Newcastle into the Venice of the North, or the New Brasilia.
I left in 67, horrified at what was happening.